Hey there. How often do you open a document and do a file save as to save a copy of the original document and then amend the new copy? Look, I know I do it all of the time. It saves me a lot of time and a lot of hassle. But did you know that there could be some private information in the original copy that has now traveled into the saved copy or the copy you've just created? A lot of people don't. So I'm going to show you where you can find that information and deal with it. Hey, I'm Sharon from Excel at Work, where we offer straightforward, non-technical assistance to help you become a confident, super productive, and super safe user of Microsoft Office. In this video, I'm going to run through the scenario of opening up an original copy, making a copy of that document, and then going and finding the information that may travel with it. I'll show you where it lives and how you can easily and confidently get rid of it, knowing that the private information is now not going to be a part of that document. I'll also show you how the information can even travel into a PDF. I know, something to watch out for sure. Hi there. So I want to talk to you about another situation that I see people get wrong quite often. And it's so easy to get wrong. I want to talk about this. This is just a normal general kind of situation that happens at work a lot. Here's a scenario. So I've sent an email to Anne saying, hey, look, you know, I've attached a quote. This obviously has gone out already to a client, and I'm just saying, hey, look, do a file save as and use this to create a copy for another company. I'm very creative with my company names, ABC Limited, XYZ Limited. So what we're doing here is we're kind of like doing something that a lot of people do many, many times throughout the week, you know, when they're working. So if I just kind of open up this file, and we'll just have a look at the information, good old enable editing. And what we're going to do here is we're just going to, obviously, you know, I could just do a file save as. So if I go file, save as, and I'll just maybe go to this PC and go into the documents, and I'll just call it XYZ quote, because I want to keep, obviously, the information that's in the quote, and I'll just make it for XYZ company. That's nice and easy. So I'll just come in here, XYZ. I won't bore you. I think you get the gist of what you'd do. And of course, you'd put their address in here. You know, I'll just make it really 789 High Street. So there we go. So obviously, it'd be a different name for the person and so on and so forth. I was making it to myself. That's really clever, isn't it? Not very creative at all. So we'll do Teddy Bear. Here we go. And we'll just go, hi, Ted, or dear Ted. There we go. So that would be easy, nice and easy. And of course, you just have to make tiny wee little tweaks to what you're actually doing. And within minutes, you can have this fantastic quote out to people. And of course, I've saved it, you know, so I know that that's obviously going to the right company. Now, I want to show you this. So if I go over to the file tab and I come down to info, and when I come down here, I want to show you something that a lot of people don't understand. Okay, so down here we have what's called metadata, and this travels with the document. Now, at this time, obviously, it's got XYZ Limited up here, but this is something I'd like you to start just checking. If you are doing a file save as, please come in here and check to make sure that there aren't any titles in here or tags, because some documents, if you're using like SharePoint folders, they can automatically be tagged when you're putting the document into them. So just be careful that there isn't kind of information in there that would look really bad if you're sending it out. Imagine if these two were competitors. So it would look terrible if you'd just gone and file save as. The other thing that I would like to point out is that it actually may hold on to the author information, where this information came from. So if I was a key account manager and obviously, you know, I'm not, if Sharon Baines isn't the key account person or isn't the key account manager for XYZ, it's meant to be Anne, that would look pretty bad if it's kind of coming from the wrong author. Another thing that I saw just recently, actually, from a friend who sent me their CV to just check to see what was in the CV and, you know, make sure that it was all good. And it was fantastic. But I did notice that, obviously, he'd taken somebody else's kind of CV and used that as a template. It was definitely his information that was in there, I can tell you that. But unfortunately, I had the person's name down in here, so I kind of went to him and said, I think you should remove that name and put your name in there, okay? So be careful. If you were sending your resume to somebody and it had somebody else's name in there, one, it may look like you didn't actually do it. Two, it may look like, you know, it's actually not an original. So if you're wanting to make sure that you are safe, of course, you can go in here and you can just delete this information out. It's pretty easy. And if you are a little bit freaked out now and you're kind of thinking, oh my goodness, really? How do I actually get, I'm just going to remove person, how do I get in and check that everything's out of there? You can go into properties, advanced properties, have a really good look through here and make sure that you're happy. There you go, there's a quote in there, a title in there. So I think if you do a right hand mouse click, no, press delete. Oh, it should actually, once I say save, it should go away. We'll just go and check that. And general, how are we looking? It's looking okay. So if I go save, and we'll go back in and have a look at those advanced properties and make sure they're all good. And contents, yeah, look at that. That's much better, isn't it? Making you feel better now. Hey, look, so there is something that you do need to understand, and I'll just quickly whip back and show you. I should have shown you before I actually changed everything, but oh, by the way, there is something called Inspect Document, and I will put a link to a blog that I've done about this. It's got a lot more information in it about using the Inspect Document if you'd want to kind of like really go through a document and make sure that it's got everything out of it, like hidden text or track changes or anything like that. You can go in there and do that. So look for that link in the description if you want it. Okay, so I will come out of here. And hopefully you kind of get that. I'm just going to shut this down. So here I am in Word again, and I just want to talk to you. I mean, nobody is perfect, and that's me. So this was me just recently. I actually did this for a client, and completely forgot, you know, to actually look and check. Here I am teaching you, and I was just in such a rush that I didn't check, and of course I'd actually just gone file, save as, and the original document was an Excel step one or stage one file. So I'll just leave that in there and I'll show you what happened. So I just went, obviously save a copy, and then I just saved it as a PDF to send off to the client. So obviously I'll just go in there. I think there might be one in there already actually. I'll just go over the top of it. There we go. And what I'll do is I'll make my way out and I'll open up that PDF, and I just want to show you how I noticed how I'd done that incorrectly. So let's go out of here. So we'll come in here and go and find that file. Here we go. And look, up here. So straight away, you can see that it's actually held on to the title from the document and popped that into the PDF settings. And of course, that would look really bad if that was another customer's name up there, especially with the word quote on it. So be careful, okay? Just slow down a little bit. What I should have done is actually gone into that Word document. I'll go back into it. And of course, I could have just gone, info, and then into here and just taken it out. Just taking it out and done a save. And of course, as soon as you save, then you know that you're all good to go. So it's actually saving because obviously it's up on OneDrive and we're good to go. So now if I was to go PDF, should we just do it? Go file and save a copy and PDF and save. It'll go over the original and yes. And we make our way down to where it is and open it up. There we go. Much better, much safer. So look, I hope what I've just gone through is helpful for you. It might have just opened up a little bit of information that you never were aware of, but I'm sure you can appreciate that it's a good idea just to slow down and go and do a check on those documents. So you can do it in Excel, Word, PowerPoint. Just go and check, okay? Make sure that it's nice and clean. And obviously, you know, if you need to get out that author, you don't want to actually have it in there. Alrighty, so yeah, let me know what you think. So I really hope that this instruction has been helpful and is going to help keep your information private. If this has been helpful, please let me know in the comments below. And if you want to stay connected, just hit that like button and please make sure that you subscribe because we're sharing new videos regularly. And if you know someone who would benefit from this help, please be sure to share this video with them. Hey, thanks for watching and have a fabulous day.